In JavaScript, there are different data types, each of them of different sizes and are allocated in different regions of memory. Hi, I'm Rohan and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS manages its memory. So, let's get to it. There are two different data types, primitive data types and non-primitive or dynamic data types. Let's look at each of them from the perspective of memory allocation. We can define primitive data types as those that contain immutable values, which means that its value cannot be changed without creating an entirely new value. It's also represented at the lowest level of the language. If we have a primitive data type that's not part of any object, array, or a function closure, then it's allocated in the stack memory. In JavaScript, there are 7 different primitive data types, which are undefined null, boolean, number, bigint, string, and symbol. The undefined data type represents an absence of a value that is automatically assigned to variables that have been declared but not initialized. The memory allocation for undefined is minimal and is typically just a few bytes. The null value represents an intentional absence of object reference. Like undefined, the memory allocation for null is also minimal, typically just a few bytes. The memory allocation for a boolean value is usually small, possibly 1 byte, but it can take up to 4 bytes. The ECMAScript standard states that a number in JavaScript is stored as a double precision 64-bit binary format, so the memory allocated to a number is 8 bytes. The BigInt type was introduced in JavaScript to safely represent large integers. The memory allocation of a BigInt depends on the size of the integer being represented. The larger the integer, the more memory it will require. However, the exact memory that is being allocated to a BigInt may vary across different JavaScript engines or implementations. JavaScript string type is represented by a set of elements. Each character in this string takes up 2 bytes of memory. However, the actual size of the string in the memory depends on the characters themselves. Some characters such as emojis or non-ASCII characters can take up more than 2 bytes. The symbol type represents unique identifiers. Each symbol value is not only unique, but is immutable. The memory allocated to a symbol depends on the JavaScript engine or implementation. It can vary, but it's generally small and typically takes just a few bytes. Now, keep in mind that these estimations are rough and might not hold true for all scenarios. Additionally, JavaScript engines employ various optimization techniques to manage memory more efficiently, which might affect the actual memory usage in live applications. In JavaScript, non-primitive data types such as objects and arrays are allocated memory dynamically. Unlike primitive types with fixed memory, non-primitive types are data structures that can grow or shrink based on the data they contain. The memory consumption of the non-primitive data types can vary based on the size and complexity of the data that is stored within them. Memory allocation of objects depends on the number and size of the properties in the object, whereas for arrays, it depends on the number of elements that is stored within them. By the way, an array is a special type of an object. Functions in JavaScript are objects too. The memory that is allocated to a function includes the code of the function itself and any variables that are captured within its closure. If applicable, the exact memory usage of a function can vary based on its implementation and all the variables that are captured. These data are stored in a different section of memory called memory heap, which is specifically used for dynamic memory allocation. So, to summarize, we have discussed different primitive data types and how much memory each of them occupy. And they are allocated in the stack memory. Different non-primitive data types, their nature as dynamic data types, and how they are allocated in the heap memory. I also want to discuss the exact memory architecture of JS and what are stack and heap memories and what important roles they play. So we will discuss these topics in the next videos. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.